Hi everyone and welcome back, it's Vicky here with a new art journal layout. I will play with lots of techniques and collage, and I'm going to work on my discbound journal here. This is a custom made one that I created with watercolor paper. I shared how I made that a few months ago, and the size of it is 8x8. So I'm going to take out one of the pages and I'm going to play with my sprays. These are Shimmer Sprays by Dilusions, and they do have lots of mica inside, which is going to stuck at the bottom of the bottle. So before you start working with them, make sure that you shake them really well. Now the colors I'm using is Steel and Jade. I'm going to spray all over my page first with water. This is going to help those colors to blend together easily, and I will not have to spray a lot. I only sprayed twice with each color. Now again I'm going back with water. I want the background to be quite light and not too saturated. That's why I didn't spray a lot. Of course you can leave your background to dry on its own. I am a very impatient crafter, so I am using my heat gun here to give it a quick dry. And now I will go back on my background with a stencil. I am using a stencil by the Crafters Workshop, and this is called Graffiti Kisses. It's one of those stencils that you can use again and again on pretty much any project. It has a very generic design, such as circles and X's and little hearts. So I have sprayed a little bit through that stencil. Now before you put on the caps and store your sprays, make sure that you wipe the nozzle. This way the mica is not going to clog the nozzle, and the next time you will use your sprays they will be good to go. Now I'm going back on my background and the same stencil. This time I'm going over the stencil with water. So I'm going to apply it in different areas there. And there is a lot of water on my stencil, so I'm just going to add some splatters all over the background. I'm going to give a few seconds for that water to react with the color that is already on my page. Remember that these sprays act as watercolors. And now I can put a dry towel on top to pick up all that water, and you can see that I got some lifting. Now I need to add some more in a few areas. That's why I'm going back with my stencil. I will do the same process until I'm happy with how my background is looking. This is a great technique to create visual texture at your background without overdoing it, and it looks subtle at the same time, although there are so many things going on back there. And here is a close-up look on how my background is looking. Now I'm going to play with collage today, and I will bring in some collage paper. This is by Studio Light and it is designed by my friend Marlene. She has a whole collection of products for art journaling, and she just came up with a new collection which I'm going to show you in an upcoming video. So I went through all those collage papers and I was looking for something very colorful, like this one that I chose, and I'm cutting out strips of this collage paper, and I will use those strips to create a border all around my background. To stick my strips of paper, I'm using my matte medium, and as you can see, I haven't been neat at all. I am not measuring anything, and certainly they are not completely straight. So I'm just going to stick them all around. It is a great way to create a border which is very colorful, and I will be working on the border more as we go on, and you will see how I'm going to add shadowing and highlighting and little doodling to bring everything together. Now I'm also going to cover up completely all those holes. I don't care at this stage how the holes are going to be covered. I can always put them back with my punch. Now from the same collage paper I'm going to cut out even more pieces which I'm going to stick on top of my page, looking as if they are heels at the background. Again I'm using my matte medium to stick everything down. You can go over the collage paper or only at the bottom if you like. And I like that they are so thin that they become a part of the page. As I said before, today I'm going to play with collage, so I'm going to use some die cuts from this blog. I'm going to show you where I got the actual idea. This is a little design with a girl and the heels at the back, so that's where I got the idea for today's project. Now I'm going to look through those two books and try to decide what I want to stick on top of my page. You will see that I'm going to grab the little tree. I'm also going to grab the girl. And I'm also going to look for flowers as well as some clouds to complete my scene. Now these two blocks of die cuts are packed with designs. They are all designed by my friend Marlene, by Art by Marlene, and they are by Studio Light. You will find all the links that you need down below in the description area, just like always. When you take the designs out of the page, you will find that they come with a white border all around. You can embrace this border. It's going to help all those die cuts to stand against the background. But I decided that I don't need that white border, so I'm using my scissors to cut it out. Now I want to add some shadows around my border, so for that I will use my scribble sticks. I'm actually using the marine color. This is the marine stick, and I will go all around the border and then dilute it with water. It's really easy to go over different surfaces with those scribble sticks, and they are water soluble. Now you can see that my border is not even at all up at the top. I am going to fix that later on. I will decide that I don't like it as it is, but for now I'm working with what I have. Now, as I'm going over that color with my water brush, you can see that the water dilutes the paint and it kind of helps to have a separated area, such as the borders from the hills and the sky. It kind of separates all those different elements. Now I'm happy with how my background is looking at the moment. I played around a little bit to decide where all the elements are going to go. And now I'm going to place them down. For sticking them down again, I'm going to use my matte medium. I find collage is a really fun technique to create art journal pages. It is very relaxing for me as I play along with all those different cutouts to try to decide where I want them to go and how to put everything together. And I absolutely love Marlene's style, so these are perfect for my book. I love all those happy colors and the lovely designs, but of course remember that you can use magazine cutouts to create beautiful layouts. I'm also going to stick down the clouds, and here is the finished piece. Now I'm going to add some details with my acrylic markers. I'm going to use different brands here with different nibs. I have some by Liquitex, others by Pebbio. You will find links to different products that I'm using down below as always. But I really have a big collection of acrylic markers. It depends on the nibs that I find every time or the colors that I like. So I am going to use the green ones here to extend the stems of my flowers. I'm using a green deco marker here, and I'm also going to add some black lines. This is a black pen by Ranger. You will find that if you use this pen, it writes over everything. It's the perfect pen for mixed media, but it takes quite a few minutes to dry. So make sure that if you use it, you don't smudge it. Now, as you can see, I'm going all around the border to add black lines to help all the elements separate from each other. And this is where I decided that I don't like the top border, which is really easy to fix. I went ahead and cut out a few more strips from my collage paper, and I'm going to stick them down with my matte medium again. And of course, once this is dry, I will go ahead and do the scribble stick and the black line to have a nice and neat finish at the top of my border. You can call this page done, of course. I can go ahead and add little details forever. So I'm using my black pen to add some doodling around the border. I'm also going to use my acrylic markers in different areas. This is going to highlight the colors, make them more vibrant. So I'm using oranges and reds, just adding color here and there. Finally, I'm going to add some white to create some doodling around the border, as well as to add some highlighting. For doing so, I'm using an acrylic marker by Liquitex. This is a Liquitex paint marker, and the color I'm using here is titanium white. And if you're wondering about the nib, they come in different nibs, these markers. I believe the one I'm using here is the 2mm chisel nib. So I'm adding highlights pretty much everywhere, on the apples, on the trees, the clouds, the flowers on top of the girl's head, and also drawing some lines all around, just adding touches here and there. And finally, it's time to add my quote. For this page, I decided to go with the one that says, "Be you, the world will adjust." It comes from a booklet by Dilusions. And this booklet is actually full of different designs and black and white doodling and lots of quotes that you can use for collage art journaling. Now my quote is in place and I'm going to call it done. So all I need to do now is to put this page back on my disc bound journal. Of course, I don't have the holes anymore, so I had to use my Happy Planner punch. And I think this planner punch is out of stock. I'm not sure. I will make sure to link down below and to other options as well. I'm really happy with how my page came out, so bright and happy. I had so much fun creating it. Here are some close-up photos on today's project. I hope that you had fun and you got inspired to play with cutouts and collage. Thank you all so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't done so already. And I'll see you next time.